Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to study an interesting topic in science, that is elements from 1 to 20. So today we are going to study the element symbol, atomic number, so and their electronic configuration.
The symbol for hydrogen is H, capital H. The symbols are case sensitive. So you have to consider this, that if the letter is capital, you have to write capital letter. Small h is wrong symbol for hydrogen. So symbols are always case sensitive. So symbol for helium is capital H small e. For lithium, Li. For beryllium, B, E. For boron, it's capital B. For carbon, it's C. For nitrogen, N. Oxygen, O. Fluorine, F. Neon, Ne. Sodium, Na. Magnesium, Mg. Aluminium, capital Al. Silicon, Si. Phosphorus, P. Sulfur, S. Chlorine, Cl. Argon, Ar. Potassium, K. Calcium, Ca. You have to remember the elements in this series only, and the symbols also. You have to remember the element like hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon, potassium, calcium, because the atomic number are in the series only. The atomic number for hydrogen is 1, for helium it's 2, similarly 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. You can write this counting 1 to 20 only if you know the elements in this series. Now, electronic configuration. What is the electronic configuration? So, electronic configuration is 2, 8, 8, that is KLM. Shell. So in first shell there are 2 electrons, in second shell there are 8, and in third also 8. So at number of electrons are according the atomic number. For example, if hydrogen has atomic number 1, then it has electrons equals to 1. So one electron to be filled in K shell. So electronic configuration is 1. For helium it is 2. For lithium, K shell contain only 2 electrons. So 2 in K, the 1 left in another shell, because it can maximum occupy 8 and minimum 0. Beryllium, 2 and 2 in similarly. For boron it's 2 and 3. For carbon it's 2 and 4, for nitrogen it's 2 and 5, it's 2 and 6. You can also verify that the sum of the numbers is always equal to atomic number. 2 plus 1, 3, 2 plus 2, 4. So electronic configuration is always, the sum of electronic configuration is always equal to the atomic number. Now you can write the electronic configuration of the left elements in similarly way. 2 and 7, 2 and 8. Now you can see here that K, L and L shell are completely filled. So their octet, it is known as their octet are complete, because K shell is also complete, L shell is also complete. No electron is loosely bound. 2, 8. Now the 11th electron goes into the M shell. 2, 8 and 8. Now, 2, 8 and 8 shell is complete. Now, the 19th electron goes into the L shell. Now we have to write the valency. So what is the valency? Valency is known as the loosely bound electron. So how many electrons are loosely bound? Only one electron is loosely bound. How many electrons are loosely bound? Zero electrons are loosely bound. So its valency is zero. How many electrons are loosely bound? This one. Two, three, four. Now here, the five electrons are filled in shell. It needs only three electrons to complete its octet. So its valency becomes three. Two electrons. One electrons, and here the octet is complete, so no electron is loosely bound, nothing is to gain, so the valency is zero. Here one electron is loosely bound, so 1, 2, 3, and 4. Similarly, five electrons are filled, it needs only three electrons to complete its octet, so three electrons is the valency, 0, here 1, and 2. Those elements whose valency is zero, that means they do not need any electron from the foreign element or to complete its octet, therefore these are known as noble gases. So which are the noble gases whose valency is zero? That is helium, number 10 neon, and also argon, number 18. Now what is the EDS? EDS is electronic dot structure. How we write H? What is the valency? 1. So we write 1 dot. For lithium, for beryllium, for boron, for carbon, for nitrogen, for oxygen, for fluorine, for neon it's zero, for sodium, for magnesium, for aluminium, for silicon, for phosphorus, for sulfur, for chlorine, for argon, for potassium, and for calcium. These dot defines the valency. How many electrons are valence? So tomorrow we will do some electronic dot structure on the basis of this table. So stay tuned to learn how to draw electronic dot structure of various compounds like H2O, for example MgCl2. So we will do this electronic dot structure tomorrow. So stay tuned to this channel and please subscribe and share this channel.